sisters. Today is today. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, today is your day of salvation.
Yes, so.
I know that you are looking around and wondering what is good about today. Today is your day. I want you to look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor that today your life is going to change.
Today my life is going to change.
Today you are now going to be a beggar.
Ever.
Today you are, from now on, you are going to be a money lender.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because the special guest we have in the house today. Hallelujah. The guest we have today is a special one. This guest. We change your life.
Yes, so my own.
I can already feel it in my spirit.
Yes, whoa.
I can already feel in my spirit what's going to happen today.
Yeah.
This special guest that we have in the house today has been around a lot. She has visited more than 40 countries. She has written more than 60 books. Can I get it?
Yeah.
She knows more than 7 languages. I want you to tell your neighbor that a special guest today is a special guest. Our guest is a bishop. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Not only she's a bishop, she's a doctor. She's a revivalist.
Yes, sir.
She is an apostle. Hallelujah!
Amen.
She is the deacon.
Amen.
This woman is going to bless your life.
Amen.
I want you to look at your neighbor now. I want you to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor that the special guest today is going to bless you with a car.
The special guest today will bless you with a car.
This neighbor is going to bless you with a child. Hallelujah!
This special guest will bless you with a child.
Your life will change today, like today. So without further ado, I am inviting our special guest to come to the pulpit and bless us today because we want to see God's revival in the house.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Yes.
Honestly, you have embarrassed me. Oh, this kind of praise is not for a mere human like me, and this is reserved for God. But I still thank you for introducing me this way. My name is, as you have heard, my name is Bishop, Doctor, Evangelist, Revivalist, Pastor, Deaconess. My name is Adassa Offense. Thank you so much for inviting me here. I know you people have waited a long time to have me here because, you know, they told me the invitation was sent like a year ago. So you people just see how busy I am just traveling here and there. But I thank you for inviting me, for honoring me,
yes,
to honor you today.
You are welcome.
Yes. Before I start, as you've heard, I've written a lot of books. And this is my latest book that I've published. Honestly, out of all the books I've published, this is the greatest and the bestest. And this book was written for, I took a long time to just be in prayer, fasting for many, many days. Actually, I even fasted for 6 months before writing this book. It has a lot of things to tell you.
Amen.
To set you free. Tell your neighbor today that when I finish reading this book, I will be set free.
When I finish reading this book, I will be set free
from all your bondage, from all those things, from all the years of barrenness, from all the years of you will be set free. You will be set free after reading this book. So make sure that before you leave this conference, you grab your own copy. I did not put a price tag to this book because as I told you, as I was fasting and praying, I was just led not to put a price tag on this copy, on this book. But you, when you get this book, just ask yourself, what kind of money should I give to Dignes Bishop, Evangelist Doctor, Revivalist Adassa Ofas? What kind of money can I give her to repay her for the labor that she has put to writing this book? This be no small money, oh. So just if you give big, you receive big. That's all I have to say. Now the title of this book is Repent Now Now. And this is even the title of my sermon today. As I was praying for this conference, I just received a revelation. And I kept on thinking, what is all this revelation? What does it mean? And as I entered this conference, I could see with my spiritual eyes that the revelation I got was true. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I can see, even now as I am standing here, I can see with my spiritual eyes the adulterers who are in these rooms. I see you. You know yourself. I see the witches. I see. I don't want to expose you. So you better confess down there. If you're an adulterer in this room, if you're a thief, if you're a gambler, if you are involved in all kind of fornication, better reveal this. Tell your neighbor, I am an adulterer. Repent now, now. Oh, come on, tell your neighbor, I am an adulterer. You're not saying anything, so it means you realize you're an adulterer. Because I want to set you free today. Repent now, now. If you're an adulterer, confess it to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, I am a thief. I am a witch. I am a wizard. You better confess it now, now. I want you people to be free. Hey, repent now, now. Now, Bible, they say, if you know the truth shall set you
free.
You people don't have enthusiasm. Are you offended by what I'm saying? I'm only telling you the truth. You know yourself. If you shall know the truth, now, what in Bible, they say, the truth shall set you free. So that's why I want you to start confessing your sins now, now. Look at your neighbor. Tell him or her, I am a thief. Because if you don't confess now, now, how can you have the blessings of God? Repent now, now. And also, before the conference started, I saw there are many pastors that have been gathering here. And it's good to be a pastor. But let me tell you, all of you pastors, swear one by one. Swear one by one if you are not collecting money from your congregation. Is this not the reason why you are growing fat everywhere? Just look at you. From top to bottom, you are just growing fat. Just running around. You are carrying bags of calories in your body. Oh, better confess to your neighbor. Say, I have stolen money from my congregation. If you are not saying it, it means that you are guilty. Come on, confess your sins because you better repent now, now. Oh, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hey, you people, hey. I'm only here to preach you what I have not done. I'm under anointing right now. And this is the anointing I got. I told you that before writing this book, I was in a 6-month prayer and fasting. So I am telling you, you better repent now, now. Oh, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. You know yourself. And also, during the time of worship and praise, I couldn't help but being disturbed by those of you pretending to be speaking in tongues. Abba, you know yourself. Can you tell me today, swear, that you are actually speaking in tongues? Or what you are doing is just repeating 3 syllables. Abba, can you translate what you just said to the Lord? Stop embarrassing yourself. Stop embarrassing yourself and stop embarrassing God. Tell your neighbor, I am only a deceiver. I don't know how to speak in tongues. So tell your neighbor that. Why must you people try to speak in tongues just because you have heard the pastor speak in tongues? You know yourself, you are just repeating these 3 syllables that you have just heard on TV, on a movie or something. I'm telling you, repent now, now. You better stop deceiving yourself. Yes, yes. Yes. Oh, right now, I can sense that in my spirit. There's someone here. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Young lady, yes, you at the back. No, not you. The other one, the one with the oversized wig. Yes, yes. Why are you frowning? Yes, it's you I'm talking to.
You better. I just got. Oh, yes, yes, yes. I just got the revelation that you are living a life of sin. Yes, 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 yes. Woohoo! Better start coming now. Come now, come now, and confess your sins to this pulpit. Yes, you sister, come. I want you. Hey.